as a boy, born and bred in Ambleside. There was one central focus point where everybody went, and that was the YMCA. So I had a go, finished up in tears. I was probably about 10 or 11 year old at the time, in the early 50s, mid 50s. I last boxed in 1967, and then very quickly after that, I got asked to coach the Windermere Boxing Club. You know, I was so pleased that perhaps people thought I was good enough. Then I became England's full-time national coach. What happened in those days was England's full-time national coach took on the role as GB Olympic coach. I did Barcelona in 92, and Robin Reid won Olympic bronze. I did Atlanta in 96. Barcelona was the first qualification tournament, and we had 9 to 10 boxers qualify for that. Reid won a bronze. Atlanta in 96, then only 2 boxers qualified. I saw it in all 12 finals, national anthems being played. And I promised myself that I would one day then stand in an Olympic stadium at the finals and hear God Save the Queen being played. And that happened in Sydney in 2000. So I suppose, you know, that's got to be an important part of it. The fact that British boxing had not won Olympic gold since Chris Finnegan in 1968. Until 2000, when Harrison won gold. Yeah, it was seeing him go through 4 contests and raising his game each time, and you know, getting it tactically right, and having the engine inside him to do it once and then pick yourself up physiologically and psychologically and go in to a quarter-final, have the next day off, pick yourself up again, semi-final, and then the big one. It was my first trip to London in 1960 when I reached the Junior Amateur Boxing Association Championship semi-finals. And if you can imagine, there was no traffic lights in Ambleside. There was no traffic lights in Windermere. You know, you didn't see traffic lights in those days. Didn't see a lot of transport. And sort of walking up out of the underground and seeing all these lights flashing, it was just, you know, so, I don't know, mesmerising and frightening, really, to the protected area of the Ambleside and the English Lakes. I want to give them some inspiration. That they're a bit laid back in Nauru. Tomorrow never comes. You know, I want to see them getting up in the morning and being busy, and you know, too many people sat about doing nothing, and they've got to get themselves out there and they've got to help themselves. They've got to have the confidence to believe in themselves and say, well, there's something in this sport that I can get something out of. If you went around Ambleside, but certainly around Windermere, and said, did you know Ian Irwin? Then most of them would say, yes, you know. It's being accepted, which I think is an important thing, and something like that gives me, you know, sort of says to me, well, Cumbria accepts you. You felt a sense of achievement, you know, at the end of the, absolutely drained, absolutely shattered, but packing your bags and driving home, and you thought, oh, you know, that was great, you know, I enjoyed doing that.